Okay. Hello, my name is Aline Sarai Vokelu. I'm from Mozambique. I started in Aichi as an MSc student from 2008 to 2010, but at the moment I'm a PhD researcher under the RISCOMEN project, which is working on the Nkomati River Basin, which is located in southern Africa. So women are very important because we are primarily the educators in Mozambique. So we are the ones who educate the children at home, for instance, how to wash their hands, to cook, and we are the ones responsible to carry water, for instance, in the rural areas. And then even on the cities, there are a lot of women involved in education and capacity building. So what we see, and research has already shown, there is a lot of impact on the education that is with girls. Like when you educate a girl, she will educate many more other people and children, and this will have a very big ripple effect. Well, from my experience with Aichi, what I feel is like, in general, there is this policy of empowering women, and a lot of work has been done in the sense of training them at BSc level, at master's level, even at doctoral level. But then you also need to take care of the environment where that lady or that woman is going to work, because many times they work in environments that are not so friendly for them to really perform to their full potential. So you see a lot of ladies that have these wonderful capabilities, but they are not able to work because they have to take care of their children, they are not able to travel, they are not able to dedicate themselves so much to research work. So a lot has to be done in terms of seeing what are the best ways of making these ladies flourish and empower even more and more women. Okay, I've been reading also quite some literature on these issues, and one of the things that is already been implemented in some countries, there is a big need of looking at our policies and making sure that we have some family-friendly policies, because one of the major obstacles that women face is that when they have to work, if they are married, if they have children, they need to have a safe place that they can let their children, some daycare facility, some childcare facility. And for instance, if you are talking of Europe, normally these are very expensive facilities. We don't have other networks to deal with these issues. So something needs to be done in terms of family-friendly policies. And this also affects the timing. Like, it's important to have flexible time schedules, maternity leaves, paternity leaves. So there are a whole bunch of issues that research already has shown that can be addressed or worked on to have women that are more empowered and more able to produce and more dedicated in their work. Yes, what we can see is that for you to change the situation of women, of course, it's a very complex issue. There are a lot of things that need to be done, but it can start from small steps. For instance, just the simple fact of putting a role model in front of a girl that she can see, okay, there are women that are doing science, that are doing research, that are able to pursue their dreams, is already a very big impact, because she can now break down these barriers that we have from our culture that women cannot do science. So this is one thing. So the other thing, the networking, because there are a lot of ladies out there that have a lot of experience, have gone through a lot of stuff, and they are able to share their experience with younger researchers and encourage them to move forward in a smoother way, let me say. So linking these ladies across cultures and across ages is also a very important step that the network and the platform can achieve. And of course, there's also the opportunity of sharing funding opportunities, project research opportunities. So all these, if we pull together, there is much more strength in women working together than when they are working individually. Yeah. Actually, maybe I give a bit of my background. So I did civil engineering in Mozambique before I came for my master's. And at the time that I was starting my studies, the statistics of classes before me was that in a class of 50 or 30 engineering students, civil engineering students, only 1 to 5 were women. On my year, on my class of 30, we were 5 ladies pursuing the same course. And when I finished my BSc, at that time I engaged on the university as a lecturer, the class that now I was lecturing was much more balanced. So you had more or less 50-50% of composition of men and women. So what we can see is like the girls, the moment they start seeing that, oh, there are other ladies that are doing this type of work, it's not just a men's work, then they're really able to follow into science and other fields of research, and they have this role model that really inspires them to go further and further. Yeah.